Hello everyone, this is Madhavi Karamudi, Assistant Professor in CLC Department. In this lecture, I'll talk about one of the most important server-side technology, that is Java Server Pages. Okay, so as the name implies, this JSP is also implemented by using Java language, just like servlets. And here, servlets and JSPs, both the technologies are developed by the Sun Microsystems people only. So what is the reason behind to go for JSP, even if we have servlet technology, is in servlet technology, there are minor difficulties over there. To overcome those difficulties, the JavaSoft people or Sun Microsystems people came with the solution in the form of JSPs. So in case of servlets, suppose if you want to create any web application, the user has to have complete knowledge on Java language and HTML. So with the little knowledge of Java, he cannot create the servlet program. So, but in the case of JSP, for creating JSP, in JSP, most of the thing or Java code we will write inside the HTML page only. And in JSP, we have lot of predefined tags just like a HTML. So little knowledge of Java language is enough for writing the JSP code. So this is the one of the most important reason because of this, most of the users are preferring this JSP for creating the web pages than servlets. Okay, but if you can compare the servlet and JSP performance wise, servlets are better than JSPs. So why I am saying this statement is, even if you write a simple JSP program by using JSP elements also, whenever you run a JSP program, internally, your JSP program will be converted into servlet program. But that conversion, that translation will be done by the JSP container itself inside the web server, right? So we will not do the conversion process. Your JSP container will do the conversion process, okay? So converting JSP code into servlet code and servlet code to class dot class file, and from the dot class file generating the response will be taking little bit amount of time. Okay, so that is the reason why performance wise servlets are better than JSPs. And one more important point we need to remember about the JSP is, whatever tasks the servlet will do, same thing we can also implement with JSPs. Okay, so JSP is just an advanced version of servlet technology, but it is not a replacement for the servlet technology. Every language, every technology contains their own advantages and disadvantages. So based on our requirement, we need to choose which technology that suits to your requirement. According to that, we need to select for our web application. Now see the advantages of JSP over Java servlets. In case of servlet programming, or if you are creating a web application using servlet programming, definitely we need to write lot of Java programs for creating the applications. But in case of JSP, we can minimize the Java code by using JSP elements. So that is the reason why This JSP page is just looking like a HTML page only. So how the HTML page contains a predefined tags, in JSP also some predefined tags are there. By seeing the tag itself, we can easily understand what the task that particular tag will do. Okay, so those tags will replace the functionality of the Java code. That is the reason why even if you have little knowledge of Java language also, that is enough for writing the JSP programs. So these JSP programs are very easy to maintain and it is very easy to understand. Now see the second advantage, in case of servlets, presentation logic and business logic we will write under single class itself. Suppose if there is a little modification in the presentation logic, like HTML code, okay, after making the changes in that HTML code, still we need to recompile that servlet program, and after recompilation we'll get the new dot class file. That new dot class file we need to redeploy into the server for the execution process. But in case of JSP, there is no need of recompilation and there is no need of redeployment. The reason here is the JSP code we will write inside the HTML page. So for running the for compiling the HTML page, no need to use any compilers. Okay, after making the modifications in the JSP elements inside the JSP page, you just give that page to the server. Your server will do all that conversion process for us. Okay, so manually, no need to recompile the program and no need to redeploy the program in the server after making the changes. So this is also one of the advantage of JSP over servlets. Now see the third advantage. So just like servlets, here JSP is also complete access on Java API. Even if it has its own predefined tags also, it can do the same task by implementing or by accessing API of Java language also. And your JSPs are just an extension for the servlets, not for the replacement of the servlets. And your JSP, in your JSP, not only predefined tags, there is a flexibility of creating our own tags by using custom tag libraries. Okay, so this is the one of the most important advantage in JSP compared to Java servlets. So with this flexibility, we can create our own tags. We can create our own tags by using custom tag libraries. Okay, now one more advantage is in JSP, we will separate the business logic completely from the presentation logic. So whenever there is a modifications in the presentation logic, without touching the business logic, we can do the changes in the presentation logic. But in the case of servlets, presentation logic, presentation code and business code, that is request processing code, we will write under the single class only. Okay, so if there is a little modifications also, after modifications we need to recompile it. Here we are separating these two things into two things. So that is the reason why if you make changes in the HTML page, no need to recompile it. Right, now see the last advantage. So compared to servlets, here in JSP we need to write less code for doing that task. Okay, so I'll prove you why we need to write less code than servlets in JSPs. I'll show it in the next slide. So these are the main advantages of JSP over servlets. Even if it have these many advantages, because of one advantage, the servlet was still alive in the market than JSPs. That advantage is performance. Performance wise, servlets are better than JSPs. Okay, now see how the JSP page is processed internally. See the JSP page processing. First of all, just like a servlet program or servlet application, here also if you want to create your web application using JSP, first of all, we need to set up the environment. Okay, the minimum things that are required for creating the JSP programs is, first of all, we need to have editor software and we need to have one browser software. We need to install a Java server machine in our Java JVM in our machine. On top of that JVM, we need to install any one of the web server. Okay, after installing of JVM, just write the JSP program in the editor. Okay, save that file using .jsp extension. Then deploy that JSP file in the server's memory space. Once the deployment is over, then for executing your JSP page, you have to follow these steps. Okay, open the browser software, send the request for your JSP page. Whenever JS request goes to the server, so here inside the server there will be multiple components, like there will be servlet container and JSP containers like that. So your servlet container will be responsible for handling, for serving requests coming for servlets. Your JSP container will handle the requests. The requests are coming for the JSP pages. So here, open the browser software, send the request for your JSP page, then your server will hand over that request to the JSP container. And your JSP container verifies whether the requested JSP page is available in the JSP container's memory space or not. Suppose if that JSP page is available in the JSP memory container's memory space, then it will read all the contents from the JSP page, and each and every line will be converted into equivalent Java instruction. Finally, it will generate one .java file. This .java file is ultimately a servlet. Okay, so these two steps, we are calling it as a translation phase. So once the .java file is ready, that .java file will be given to the Java compiler. Your Java compiler will compile your .java file and it will generate the .class file. So this .class file is used for processing your request. Now the JSP container will process your request by executing this .class file. Finally, that generated response will be sent back to the client as a HTML page or in the form of web page to the client. So this is the process done inside the server whenever you send a request for your JSP page. Okay, let us see the life cycle of a JSP. So here, in JSP life cycle, we will see multiple phases. First of all, your JSP page will be converted into equivalent Java program. After that, Java servlet life cycle will start. Okay, so first of all, your JSP page is converted into servlet program. After that, the servlet life cycle will start. Let us see the life cycle of a servlet. Here, just assume that here I have written one JSP page. That file name is test.jsp. So I need to store that test.jsp file inside the server's memory space. So after that, your server will initiate the execution of JSP compiler. Okay, your JSP compiler converts your JSP file into .java file. This .java file is given to the Java compiler. Your Java compiler will convert this .java file into .class file. So this and four steps and this entire process will be done inside the JSP container. Okay, finally, from this .class file, by using this .class file, your container will process your request and it will generate the response. That generated response will be sent back to the client. See one more diagram for your for the JSP life cycle. Okay, same process. Here, first the JSP page will be converted into servlet file. That phase we are calling it as a translation phase or translation stage. Okay, so who will convert your JSP file into servlet file? Your JSP compiler, right? After that, that servlet file is given to the Java compiler. Your Java compiler will convert that .java file into servlet class file. Okay, so this process is called as compilation stage. Now the servlet class is ready to process your request. Now from here onwards, the servlet life cycle will start. As usual, in servlet life cycle, first the init method will be executed for initializing your servlet class. Then the service method will be executed for processing your request. Once all the requests are processed, then the destroy method will be invoked. So again, up to this process, this is the JSP translation phases. From here onwards, the servlet life cycle will start. Okay, so here also see the init method. Instead of calling it as servlet init method, here we'll call it as JSmin. In the automatically generated servlet, we'll have a init method like this, JSP init method. And we'll have a service method like underscore JSP service method. And we'll have one destroy method like this. So this init method will be executed only once, just like a servlet init method. And your service method will be executed multiple times according to your request. Finally, at the end, your JSP destroy method will be executed for deallocating the memory that is allocated for all your JSP elements. Okay, these are the steps involved in the JSP lifecycle. Now see one example servlet program. One example program on JSP as well as servlets. So with this example, we can see which is easier to code, which technology is easier to code. See one simple servlet program first. So here, this servlet program I am writing for displaying welcome message. Okay. So for writing welcome message, for printing welcome message in servlet program, first of all, we need to import the servlet packages and we need to import one IO package for printing purpose because the print method is available in this IO package. Then we need to write one servlet program extends from any of the servlet class. So here I am extending from the HTTP servlet class. Then we need to write the service method for processing the request. And inside the service method, here I am writing some HTML contents for printing the welcome message on the screen. Right? So this is the servlet program for printing welcome message. Now see the equivalent JSP program for this servlet. Okay, so here how many lines we are writing for printing the welcome message on the screen? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 lines of code we are writing for printing one simple welcome message on the screen. Now see the equivalent Java program for this. So simple HTML page, HTML head title, head close body, just welcome message. And this is a JSP element, JSP element. In the next class, next slide, I'll explain what are the JSP elements. So in this JSP elements, I am writing one message for printing it on the screen, executing JSP program. And I am closing the body part and HTML part. So in the previous example, we have written 16 lines of code. Just see in this example, how many lines we are writing? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And this is completely HTML code. Okay, so if you can understand, which is easy to understand. Once you write this program, you have to save this program with .jsp extension. Now, if you compare these two programs, which is easy to code, definitely JSP is very easy to code. So this is the main reason why we need to go for